Christ did not sin or ever tell a lie. Although he was abused, he never tried to get even. And when he suffered, he made no threats. Instead, he had faith in God, who judges fairly. Christ carried the burden of our sins. He was nailed to the cross so that we would stop sinning and start living right. By his cuts and bruises, you are healed. You had wandered away like sheep. Now you have returned to the one who is your shepherd and protector. Those words come from 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 22 to 26. Why did Jesus never try to get even with those who abused and even crucified him? They will have to face the judgment of God on a day appointed by him unless they first repent and turn their hearts to Jesus, which is what Jesus wanted them to do. When you lash out at someone who has done you wrong, you are directing your anger and vengeance at the very person Jesus came to save. Imagine if someone had given Saul what he deserved for killing Christians. There would have been no Apostle Paul and all the blessings that came from God through him. If you are patient and trust God to work his amazing calling on the hearts of those who cause you to suffer, then often the persecutor will become a precious brother. You see, it is not who you are now that matters. It is who you will become by the power of Jesus. Even when you look in a mirror, you see a man or woman who has not yet completed the course and finished the race. But God sees what you will become as you are ushered into his presence to live with him forever. God will judge those who never turn to Jesus. But our job now is to love them and lead them to the foot of the cross. Lord Jesus, thank you for loving me when I was still your enemy. Help me today to love those who cause me to suffer for you, so that they too may come to know you, the only true God. Amen.